You're listening to Dan McCarty High Radio, WDMH.
Radio. Non-stop gold!
Welcome back, Eagles, to our May show 2014, the Psychedelic Sixties. Now, this show is guaranteed to bring back some memories, but that is, of course, dependent upon how active you were in the Psychedelic Sixties. This is your co-host, David Barnes. You know, we as a generation have lived through a lot, and one of the more colorful, or should I say cooler, aspects of our youth was that it occurred right in the middle of the psychedelic era. Yeah, baby. At a time in the mid to late 60s when music, art, and yes, some would even say our whole generation was influenced by the widespread use of mood-altering, hallucinogenic drugs. The best among them was, of course, LSD. Oh, yeah. I mean, no matter what your stance on drugs was then or is now, it is hard to ignore the impact that these hallucinogenics had on the music of our era. No, Mom and Dad, I didn't use, you know. So today's WDMH radio show is about that cool psychedelic music. So let's kick it off, and let's bring up Mr. Keeping the Spirit Alive himself, Richard Parker.
Hey, gang, and welcome back. We're going to kick off this month's show with Jefferson Airplane, a San Francisco group that was formed in 1965 and was a pioneer in the psychedelic rock era. The group was the first band from the San Francisco scene to achieve international mainstream success. They performed at the three most famous American rock festivals of the 1960s, Monterey in 1967, Woodstock and Altamont in 1969. The 60s were a time of super bands, but none were more super than the three-member band Cream. They were, in fact, the cream of the crop of the 60s psychedelic scene. The three members of Cream were bassist and vocalist Jack Bruce of Manfred Mann, Eric Clapton of the Yardbirds, along with the madman drummer of the 60s, Ginger Baker.
You know, Richard, no list of psychedelic songs would be complete without the anthem for the psychedelic era and one of my favorites, In a Gotta Da Vida.
Oh, do you mean the song that Johnny Walker named?
That Johnny Walker named? What are you talking about, Richard?
Well, as legend has it, the song was written by Doug Engel, Iron Butterfly's vocalist and keyboard player. His father was a church organist. The title was supposed to be In the Garden of Eden. But after a very long and alcohol-soaked, I might add, recording session, someone scribbled In a Gotta Da Vida on the demo copy. more than one of the band members stated that it maybe had a little bit to do with the two bottles of Johnny Walker consumed during the session. A record company executive saw it and decided to use that as the title, since it sounded mystical and Eastern spirituality was big at the time, with the Beatles going to India and the Rolling Stones experimenting with Indian instruments.
Cool, so now we know the rest of the story. Okay, how about a little taste of In the Garden of Eden?
Absolutely, my friend.
You know that I'm loving you. In a God of a Vita, baby, don't you know that I'll always be true. Oh, won't you come with me and I'll take my hand. Oh, won't you come with me and I'll walk this land. In a garden of Eden, honey, don't you know that I'm loving you? In a garden of Eden, baby, don't you know that I'll always be true?
Well, Richard, I guess I just about bring show number 5 to a close.
Well, almost, David. You got your last request with In a Garden of Eden. How about giving me one more swing at that psychedelic baseball?
Sure, what's your pleasure?
Well, David, how about we roll on down the tracks with a little Grand Funk Railroad to take us to the hacienda?
You couldn't have picked better. Here you go.
I'm
Well, gang, that wraps up another DMHS radio show for this month. Now, we always enjoy your comments on the show, so stop by our forum, and when you get a chance, let us know what you think of this month's show, and we always welcome any suggestions you may have. Again, thank you, Richard, for all your time, hard work, to research and produce this show. See you all next month. Good night, Richard.
Good night, David.
Dude, go easy on the door this time.